Solve the limit as x approaches 7 in the function the square root of x plus 2 minus 3 divided by x minus 7. Mentally putting in 7 for x, the square root of 7 plus 2 minus 3 divided by 7 minus 7. 7 plus 2 is 9, the square root of 9 is 3. 3 minus 3, that's a 0 in the denominator, and 7 minus 7 is also 0. We have another case of the indeterminate form 0 over 0. To work with sums and differences of roots, we're going to multiply by the conjugate. We have the square root of x plus 2 minus 3. The conjugate of that is the square root of x plus 2 plus 3, and then we multiply that quantity to the numerator and the denominator. So essentially we're multiplying by 1, but it's a really helpful one. The next part is slightly trickier. We have to be very meticulous in expanding the numerator. The denominator, we just keep it factored. Foiling the numerator, so the first terms, the square root of x plus 2 multiplied by the square root of x plus 2. Outer terms, square root of x plus 2 multiplied by 3. Inner terms, negative 3 multiplied by the square root of x plus 2. And last terms, negative 3 multiplied by 3. And again, we leave the denominator factored. Now we simplify. Notice that the middle terms cancel, which is why we needed to multiply by the conjugate. It's something with a different sign. If we didn't have a different sign, then we would have these middle terms that remain, and that's going to cause more problems. So in this case, we multiply by the conjugate correctly, the middle terms cancel. When we have two of the same roots, in this case, root of x plus 2, two of those things multiply together, essentially square it, and squaring it gets rid of that radical, the square root. Negative 3 times 3 is a negative 9. We now have x plus 2 minus 9 divided by a bunch of awful looking stuff. Simplifying the numerator, we have the 2 and the minus 9 giving us a minus 7, which conveniently cancels the x minus 7 factor in the denominator. Canceling these two factors will cancel that problem spot that causes the indeterminate form. Notice that the numerator isn't 0. When we cancel these factors by division, we actually get a 1. It's only when we subtract that we get a 0. But in this case, we're dividing. 1 in the numerator and denominator, we got rid of that x minus 7. We just have the square root of x plus 2 plus 3. There's no longer an indeterminate form, so let's take the limit. Substitute in 7 for x. And simplifying, we have 1 over 7 plus 2 underneath the radical. So 7 plus 2 is 9. The square root of 9 is 3, and then 3 plus 3 is 6. So our answer is 1 over 6. Remember,